You invest $1,000 in a stock that earns 8% per month. Write a model for this situation. Rewrite your model to show the annual growth rate. Okay, so the model for this situation earns 8% per month, and a stock compounds the earnings. So we're going to use exponential growth. There's our general formula. F of x equals a b to the x. A is the initial amount. B is the growth factor. Initial amount is $1,000. So let's go ahead and get more specific. Function of time, f of t, is $1,000. And then 8% per month is the growth rate. That means 1.08 is the growth factor. So we're going to be multiplying by 1.08. And t is in terms of months. Okay, so this shows per month what's happening. The next part is rewrite your model to show annual growth rate. Now, annual means per year. There are 12 months in a year. So what we need to do is figure out, okay, if you multiply repeatedly by 1.08 each month, really you're multiplying in a year by 12 times that amount. So it's going to be 1.08 to the 12th power is what you're going to be doing. Okay, now we can't just change the exponent inside the parentheses here without correcting for that outside the parentheses. So what we're going to do is use one of the properties of multiplication. We're going to use a property of exponents to make sure it all works out even. So we're going to divide by 12 out here. So here's what happens. You're saying 1.08 is your growth factor. And what I'm doing is using a little math trick. So I'm going to say it's to the 12th. And then to the 1/12th. Power to a power rule. This is the same thing as 1.08 to the 12 over 12, and the 12 over 12 reduces to 1, so it's still 1.08. What I'm doing is I'm rewriting it in this function up here, applying this to show what happens over a year. So in 12 months, you're going to multiply by 1.08 12 times, so it's 1.08 to the 12th. But to make sure the function doesn't change its value, we're dividing by 12. And that also works well here. If we're inputting months, they're going to be 12 months in a year. So to make this years, you divide by 12. So in 12 months, you'd have 1 year. 12 divided by 12 is 1. That means the growth rate here applies to 1 year. So this is kind of an advanced application of the power to a power rule. Now to finish this off, I'm going to figure out what 1.08 to the 12th power is. And that will show the annual growth rate. So 1.08 to the 12th, 2.518, or I'll just round it to 2.52. Okay, so here's our growth factor. 2.52, the annual growth factor. So the annual growth rate would be 1.52. Okay, so just to clarify, 2.52, that's your annual growth factor. 1.52 is your annual growth rate. So let's translate that into regular language. The stock earns 8% per month, will earn 152% per year. And that means it would be about 2.5 times, which is the 2.52.